Portuguese classification of breeds and their components. In this session, we cover the components, components of breeds, and classification of breeds. Now, let's start with what is breeds. A breeze is a structure for carrying the road traffic or other moving loads over a depression or obstruction such as river, channel, road or railway. Now, components of breeze. The main three components of breeze are substructure, superstructure and adjoining structure. Now, what is substructure? A component of a breeze below the level of the bearing is known as substructure. It is consists of the abutment, pier, wing wall and foundation for abutment and pier. Now, superstructure. The components of a bridge above the level of the bearing is known as superstructure. It consists of the beam, girders, bearings, arch, cable, parapet wall, handrails and flooring, etc. Now, adjoining structure. It consists of the approaches, river trailing works like guide bank, aprons, etc. Now, classification of bridge. Based on material used as per alignment, location of bridge floor, purpose, types of superstructure according to high flood level, according to span, span length, navigation facility and life of bridge and last as per loading. Now, classification of bridge based on material. Timber bridge, stone masonry bridge, RCC reinforced cement bridge and steel bridge. Pre-stressed bridge and composite bridge. उसमें जो भी material है वो mix होके हम use करते हैं. Classification of bridges based on alignment. First one is straight alignment bridge. When the alignment of bridge is perpendicular to the central line of the river, it is called straight bridge or square bridge. Second one is screw alignment. When the alignment of a bridge is not perpendicular to the central line of a river, it is called screw bridge. Second one is classification of bridge based on location of floor. Deck bridge. When the bridge flooring is provided at the top of the superstructure, it is called deck bridge. Through bridge. When the bridge flooring is provided at the bottom of the superstructure, it is called through bridge. Third one is semi-through bridge. When the bridge flooring is located at some intermediate level in the superstructure, it is called semi-through bridge. Classification of bridge based on purpose. Aqueduct. It is small bridge constructed over a stream which remains dry for most part of the year. It is called aqueduct. Viaduct. It is long, continuous structure which carries a road or railway like a bridge over a dry valley composed of a series of span over terrestrial band instead of solid piers. Grade separator. When two roads crosses each other or road and railway lines crosses each other and there is considerable difference in the formation level, a bridge structure is constructed which is known as grade separator. Classification of bridge based on purpose. Highway bridge, it is constructed on a roadway for the movement of vehicles. Railway bridge, it is constructed for railway. Footbridge, a footbridge is a bridge exclusively used for carrying a pedestrian, cycle and animals. Pipe bridge, it is used for support pipeline for water, gas, oil, etc. Now, classification of bridge based on superstructure. Slab girder. When the span of bridge is 3 to 6 meter, it is called slab bridge. Girder bridge. When the span of bridge is more, flooring is supported on RCC or steel girder. Such type of bridge is called girder bridge. Truss bridge. When the flooring of a bridge is supported over the steel trusses, it is called truss bridge. Suspended bridge. Suspended bridge consists of a cable hanging in a curve from which the road is supported. Arch bridge. In such type of bridge, the weight of the flooring is transferred to the pipe pierced through the arch. Now, classification of bridge according to high flood level. According to high flood level, bridges are classified as submersible bridge and non-submersible bridge. First one is submersible bridge. A road causeway is a picade which allows food to pass over it. It may or may not have open or vent for the low water of flow. Non-submersible bridge means in these types of bridge, formation level of the road is kept above the high flood level so that maximum flood does not affect the traffic of the bridge. Now, classification of bridge according to span. Distance between two piers is called span. Simply supported beam. When the bridge girders are simply supported on pier is known as simply supported bridge. Continuous bridge. When the superstructure of a RCC bridge is continuous over more than two supports, it is called continuous bridge. Cantilever bridge. A cantilever bridge is formed of cantilever's projection from the supporting piers. The ends of the cantilever bridge are treated as a fixed. Balanced cantilever bridge. A balanced cantilever bridge consists of a span simply supported over cantilevers as shown in figure. It can be used for span varying from 35 to 60 meter. Now, classification of bridge according to span length. First one is culvert. When the bridge span length up to 8 meter is called culvert. Minor bridge. Span length is 8 to 30 meter is known as minor bridge. Major bridge. In major bridge, span is 30 to 120 meter. And last one is long span bridge. Span bridge above the 120 meter is known as long span bridge. Now, classification of bridge according to navigation facility. Movable spans of bridge are sometimes used over the navigation channel. Swing bridge. In case of swing bridge, a central pier is provided with a suitable bearing called rollers. Bascule bridge. In bascule bridge, the entire superstructure is rotated in a vertical plane above the horizontal axis. Third one is lift bridge. In this type of bridge, the truss is lifted up. Transporter bridge. In case of transporter bridge, a moving cage is suspended from the overhead truss with the help of cables, wire or wire ropes, as we can see in this figure. Now, classification of bridge according to life of bridge. First one is temporary bridge. The bridge which are constructed and maintained at low cost and have short span of life are called temporary or low cost bridge, like pontoon bridge, flying bridge. Second one is permanent bridge. These are bridges which are constructed and maintained at high cost and have long span of bridge, like RCC bridge, steel bridge, masonry bridge, etc. Now, classification of bridge as per loading. First one is class AA bridge, class A bridge and class B bridge. Hope you people are getting some valuable knowledge about classification of bridge and their components. Now friends, here I give you some multiple choice questions link to evaluate your knowledge gained from this video session. In last, thank you.